So now, in part three on unemployment, I want to go ahead and ask, where does the natural rate of unemployment come from? And there's two different ways we might answer this question. One is, how do we figure out what it is? And the other way of thinking about it is, what influences what the natural rate of unemployment is? And there's two ways of thinking about how do we figure out what it is. And the fancy word for figure out here is, how do we estimate the natural rate? And there's two approaches. One approach, and this is basically what I did or referred to earlier, is look at long-run average unemployment rate. A potential problem with that approach is that if we think, say, for instance, a country has had a recession and it's been stuck in a recession for a very long time, then we're going to sort of confuse the issue of how much of the unemployment we're seeing is a recession and how much is due to the basic underlying structure of that economy. The other way of looking at it is more related to what economists call the NAIRU, which stands for the non-accelerating, so that's an N, that's our N and our A, our non-accelerating inflation rate of unemployment. And the idea here is that when we stimulate the economy, when we ask the economy to produce more goods and services, of course, that's going to cause more workers to be hired, and it's going to cause the unemployment rate to go down. At the same time, as firms produce more, then they're going to run up against production constraints, and their costs are going to rise. And even if their costs don't rise that much, as we demand more of them, they're going to go ahead and have the opportunity or the temptation to raise prices, because essentially our demand will be higher, and when we have a higher demand, that's going to lead to higher prices. So the question here is, how low can we push unemployment before we cause inflation to accelerate? And notice we use the word accelerate here rather than occur. So the idea here is, it might be that we can push unemployment or have unemployment go from 8% down to 7%, and inflation is at 2% that whole time. But then maybe when we push unemployment down to 6%, inflation goes up to 3%. So this is the acceleration of inflation, not just that inflation's happening at 2% per year, but it's happening at a faster pace, 3% per year. I personally actually prefer thinking about unemployment in terms of the NAIRU, but for most purposes, the difference between thinking about it in terms of the NAIRU and the natural rate of unemployment are pretty small, so either one of those will do. And I might occasionally use those two terms interchangeably. The second question is, what determines whether the natural rate or NAIRU is high or low? And economists often want to break these things down, so we're going to not worry about the differences here between the natural rate and the NAIRU, as thinking about the NAIRU or natural rate is made up of two types of unemployment, one of which is relatively benign and not super harmful, and the other that we worry more about. So the kind of unemployment that economists don't worry about as much is what we call frictional unemployment. Frictional unemployment refers to a situation where the number of people wanting to work matches up with the number of jobs available, but it just takes time for people to find that match. And sort of by way of a analogy, you might imagine, say for instance, a small village where everybody wants to get married eventually, and the number of men and the number of women is equal, but it takes time for people to find that certain someone, so there's always some population of single adults out there. So frictional unemployment, by its nature, essentially tends to be short-lived, because again, there's no sort of persistent mismatch between the number of people who want work and the number of jobs available. Structural unemployment is a potentially much more worrisome situation, and that refers to a situation where the number of people who want work at the current level of wages and so on and so forth is significantly greater than the number of jobs available. And remember, because we're talking about the NAIRU or natural rate of unemployment, we're talking about even if the economy is not in a recession, that somehow in some places and sometimes there's just sort of persistent unemployment. And essentially, if you think about a labor market, what we're saying here is that somehow at the current wage, the quantity of labor that firms want to hire, quantity demanded of labor, is less than the quantity supplied of labor, because the number of people who want to work is the quantity supplied of labor, the number of jobs available is the quantity demanded of labor. So somehow we're having an above equilibrium wage. So almost all of our stories about structural unemployment are going to talk about why are we having an above equilibrium wage, and why are we having this situation of surplus labor? So surplus labor and unemployment are basically the same thing. And why aren't wages adjusting? Because normally we think in most markets that prices adjust down to make the market equilibrium level. So most of our candidate explanations for having a high structural unemployment rate are going to have to be some kind of story about wages being above equilibrium level, or wages not declining, or something like that. We'll go ahead and go through those in some of the last parts of this lecture series, but first I'm actually going to cover just some plain old data about labor markets in the next segment.